Okay.
Welcome to worship from the church at Cars Lane. This morning worship's led by myself, Neil Johnson, our student, Jason McMahon. Music's by Tim Batty, and the production team is Chris and Ruth York. Some opening notices. So first of all, we've got online Advent Bible study led by Sarah and Jason, entitled Now and Then, Reflecting on 2020 Through the Christmas Story. These will take place at 11 in the morning each Friday. And then Listening Together, led by Christina and Julie, 11 o'clock in the morning on Monday the 30th of November, that's tomorrow, and then on Monday the 21st of December. So welcome to this worship on this Advent Sunday. Advent is the season of hope, when we prepare to celebrate the birth of Jesus. Each Sunday during Advent and Christmas, we've chosen a certain theme to give a focus to our worship. And on this Advent Sunday, the theme is waiting. Jason is going to light the first Advent candle. And let us pray. Lord God, we come as your people, many still feeling that we are waiting in darkness, but believing in the hope of your wonderful light. We this Advent look for your light in Jesus. We pray for those who recently celebrated light in Diwali, and those soon celebrating Hanukkah. We pray especially for people in MHA care homes and their staff, remembering on this first Sunday of Advent that they and we, though in different places, are all your people. We thank you for staff and residents, for care, resilience and commitment. We come together today as your people, wherever we are, in community, living alone, in care homes, in families. May we all know the sure hope of your promise. Amen. Our first hymn this morning is 180 from Singing the Faith. O come, Emmanuel.
We turn now to our prayers of praise and confession. Let us pray. God, your name is love, and in your great love you have called us into community with each other. With you and in you and because of you, we are nurtured in love. Yours is the name that lasts forever. Your love reaches into all corners, confirming those who wait for you, that they wait in the name of great love. Amen. And as we wait for you, we recognize that we have turned our face from you, O God. Your face is always turned towards us. We have forsaken what we know is just. We have ignored what we understand is true. We have refused to believe what should be believed. We have deceived ourselves in word and deed. For this, we humbly repent, and we turn our face towards you, who waits for us and makes us ever new. Make us ever new now, O restoring God. We pray for your loving forgiveness to wash over us. In the name of your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ the Messiah. Amen. We share now our Bible reading taken from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 to 10. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to the peoples. The nations shall inquire of him, and his dwelling shall be glorious. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Advent is a time of anticipation, a time of hope, a time of waiting. Samuel Beckett's famous play, Waiting for Godot, was once described as a drama in which nothing happens twice. It tells the story of two men, Vladimir and Estragon. And throughout the whole of the play, they're waiting. But waiting for what? There's been much speculation about that. Were they waiting for a friend? Were they waiting for death? Were they waiting for a Messiah? At one point in the play, these words are uttered. What are we doing here? That is the question. And in this immense confusion, one thing alone is clear. We are waiting for Godot to come. In much of the Old Testament, you get a sense of anticipation, a sense of hope, a sense of waiting. The God of the Old Testament is a God of promises. And so the people of God wait. Wait for those promises to be fulfilled. And after the glory days of King David's reign, there were hopes and dreams of a son of David, a new Messiah, an anointed one. And these hopes were heightened in the time of exile in Babylon around 600 BC. For this was the time of the great prophet Isaiah and his vision of a new age to come, when the wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. This vision of a new age of peace, of justice, of equality. This vision sustained the people as they waited. Waited for hundreds of years, waiting for the Anointed One, the Son of David, their Messiah to come among them. The composer of Matthew's Gospel retells an incident in chapter 11, when one day the followers of John the Baptist come to Jesus and ask him, "Are you the one who is to come? Or are we to wait for someone else?" And Jesus replies to them. He says, "Go back to John and tell him what you've heard and what you've seen. The blind see, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have received good news." In other words, Isaiah's vision of a world reordered had been realized, which meant at long last the waiting had come to an end. Throughout my childhood, the world waited for nuclear Armageddon. And now that's been replaced by ecological disaster, compounded by the impact of the current global pandemic. For generations, the world's waiting has been based on fear and not on hope. Although that fear often led to worldwide campaigns, such as C&D and the Green Movement, there's often little thought to an alternative way of life. There's little vision of a new age of peace and justice and equality. There's little time given to living in hope. This is the great challenge to us as Christians in this time of Advent. We pray to God, your kingdom come, which should mean living on earth as if in heaven. It should mean being a model of hopeful people. It should mean offering a new vision to the world. So, as I was saying, in this time of Advent, the season of anticipation, the season of hope, the season of waiting, as we prepare to celebrate the birth of the long-expected Jesus, when the world still lives in fear, my question is, what are we waiting for? Our next hymn is 171, Hark the Glad Sound, the Saviour Comes, and we're going to hear Chris Grove singing it, accompanied by Tim Batty.
Glad sound, the Saviour comes, the Saviour promised long. Let every heart prepare a throne, and every voice a song. He comes, the prisoners to release, in Satan's bondage held. The gates of brass before him burst, the iron fetters yield. He comes, the broken heart to bind, the bleeding soul to cure, and with the treasures of his grace to enrich the humble poor. Our glad hosannas, Prince of Peace, your welcome shall proclaim, and hymns eternal arches ring with your beloved name.
We share now our prayers of intercession together. And there is a response that you can join in with from home. When I say, we are waiting Jesus, if you could respond with, come and live with us soon. We are waiting Jesus, come and live with us soon. Let's pray. Jesus, we are waiting because we know who you are, the creator of the world, the God who took on human form, the son of Mary, a girl just like any other girl. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Jesus, we are waiting because we have faith in you. We know that we can trust you. We remember that you are good to us, and we thank you for all the good things that you give to us every day. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Jesus, we are waiting here, here in Birmingham, here in our homes, wherever we are watching this service, waiting for you to come into our houses, our streets, our places of work and education, to fill them with your light and peace. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Jesus, we are waiting for you to come and change things, to bring health to our sick ones, to make our asylum seekers welcome, to comfort those who have lost loved ones, and to turn us around so that we can be your hands and feet, your ears and eyes, in this world that needs you so much. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Amen. And we pray now the words that our Saviour taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We share now our final hymn from Singing the Faith, number 178, Long Ago, Prophets Knew.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the hope of Advent be known to each one of us as we wait upon God, our Creator, Companion, and Cherished One, this season and always. Amen.